From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. The Portland man charged with last week's murder on Grand Street made his first court appearance this afternoon. 25-year-old Sean Garland did not enter a plea at today's hearing. Police say on Thursday night he stabbed and killed 58-year-old Richard Myers of Portland. Police say the two knew each other. Garland is being held without bail at the Cumberland County Jail. Investigators have released the names of the two men killed in Saturday's plane crash in the town of Harrison. The Cumberland County Sheriff's Department says the pilot was 68-year-old George Fortin of Naples and his passenger was 73-year-old Anatoly Kalinick from Harrison. Family members say Fortin left the Leamington Airport early Saturday and then picked up Kalinick at a private strip in Harrison. When they didn't come back, family members called police. Search crews found the wreckage Sunday morning in some woods near Route 35 in Harrison. Police say it looks like the pilot was trying to land in a field but hit some trees on the way down. The crash remains under investigation. A top economic official with the Obama administration was in Maine today, getting a better sense of the economic challenges facing our state. Along with Congresswoman Shelley Pingree, the Assistant Secretary of Commerce for Economic Development, John Fernandez, visited Biddeford and Portland. We caught up with them during the tour of the Portland Fish Exchange. Pingree asked Fernandez to visit the state to see firsthand the economic development opportunities and challenges here in Maine.
But this is really important work that I do in terms of being able to go out into regions throughout America, do roundtable discussions with small business people, community leaders, to really get a sense of some of the challenges that they face, and then that really informs the kind of policies we focus on and how we frame our own programs to make sure that we're being responsive.
As head of the U.S. Economic Development Administration, Fernandez is charged with leading the nation's economic development agenda. In addition to the fish exchange, Fernandez toured the Portland waterfront, took part in an economic roundtable discussion, and toured the North Dam Mill in Biddeford. The Portland Fire Department is launching a fundraising effort to equip its stations with pet oxygen masks that will help the family pets in the event of a fire. As it stands now, rescue workers must treat animals suffering from smoke inhalation with oxygen masks that are made for people. But because they don't fit so well, pets don't always get the fresh air they need. So the Planet Dog Foundation and Portland Fire Department are asking pet lovers to help them raise $3,000, enough to buy small, medium, and large masks for all 8 city fire stations.
Typically, your dogs and cats are very resourceful. They'll escape themselves. But occasionally, we run into that tragic situation where there's a pet that's overcome outside of the building or just inside the structure that we're able to pull to the outside or even give some treatment to. And these pet oxygen masks will go a long way in delivering high-flow oxygen.
And you can make a donation at the Planet Dog on Marginal Way. The masks cost around $40 a piece. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.